In this video, you will learn how to use the drop-down list feature in Google Docs. Number 1. Add drop-down through the Insert menu. We have this table and we want to add a status, so we head into Insert, drop-down, and there we have two presets. We're going to choose Project Status. Now that will add a status or a drop-down here into this cell, and I can go ahead and say copy this. I'm just going to mark it like so. I'm going to copy, and then I'm going to select these cells and paste them in here like that. And now I just go ahead and choose whatever status is applicable for this specific task. I'm going to leave this on that. So here you see these four status that come from the project preset. Number 2, add dropdown through the Add Search menu. We're going to add a custom menu this time. So we're going to type add, and this lets us search through our menu. There you go, drop down. So I can click on the tab button, and now I can choose, I would like to create a new drop down with these options. So let's say the options are, in this case, we're gonna say awesome, good, and let's give it a nah. And we can delete any options we don't need. We can customize the colors here, which we're gonna do right now. Let's give it like so. This is going to be bluish, and this is gonna be red. I click on save. So there you go. This is now awesome. And if I wanted to, again, I find the easiest way is just to copy this and then paste it below. If you found a better way to do this, then let us know in the comments section below. And now you can go ahead and change this round like so. Number 3, customize dropdown. Simply click on the status, then add edit options. And let's say we wanted to change the color for the not started. Let's swap this out for something kind of bluish. Once I hit save, since multiple instances of this specific status are already on our document, I can say that I want to apply this change just to the specific instance that I'm changing or apply to all. We're gonna do that for all. So now all not start are bluish. And why don't we do the following too? How about we add an emoji? Now I can do that on my Mac by hitting the function key, adding the starry-eyed emoji, clicking on save, applying to all. There you go, some emoji action. Leave us a like if you've learned something new in this video, and please go ahead and subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming video tutorials.